to stand for a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you this morning for this opportunity given unto us to come to have a fellowship with you. Heavenly Father, I know, as it was in the beginning, that every time in the evening time, you were coming down and you had fellowship with Adam and Eve in the Garden of Eden. Father, you are the one said, where two or three are gathering in my name, I'm in their midst. We didn't come in the name of any religion. We are coming to hear from thee because we truly believe that you are the everlasting God who speaks to his children. As it is also recorded, my sheep hear my voice and they follow me. Heavenly Father, we are not following any man. We are following our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, because we truly believe that he is the same yesterday, today, and forever. We come in thy presence, believing and trusting that this morning you are the only one who will speak to each one of us. Father, not unto us, not unto us, but give praise and glory to our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Thank you. Come and take over from the beginning until the end of this sermon. We truly believe that thy presence in our midst, because we are praying in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for everything. In Jesus Christ's name, I have prayed. Amen. We may be seated. From our song book, song 79, and I'm thanking all the brethren who decided to come and have a fellowship with the Lord Jesus Christ this morning. Sing from this song book, song 79. 7-9. Down from his glory, ever-living story, my God and Savior came, and Jesus was his name. Born in a manger, to his own stranger, a man of sorrows, tears, and agony. Oh, I'm laughing, oh, how adoring, my breath, my sunshine, my only hope. The great Creator became my Savior, and all God's fullness dwelleth in me. What condescension brings us redemption, that in the dead of night no one can hope inside. God gracious tender, let aside his crown, stooping to wood to him save my soul. Oh, how I love him, how I adore him, my breath, my sunshine, my holy God. The great Creator became my Savior, and all God's fullness dwelleth in me. without relentless flesh and blood substance. He took the form of man, breathing they didn't plan. Oh, glorious mystery, sacrifice of Calvary. And now I know that where the great I am. Oh, how I love him, how I adore him, my faith, my sunshine, my holy world. The great creator became my savior, and all God's fullness dwelleth in him. Yes, brethren, as the chorus says, oh, how I love him. My breath, my sunshine, my all in all, the great creator became my savior. And all God's fullness dwelleth in him. We shall sing also song number 78, just next to that. And then we shall go to the word of prayer, to the word of today. Such love. That God should love a sinner such as I, should yet prove change my sorrow to bliss, nor rest in thee, I plan to bring in man. How wonderful is love like this? Such love, such wondrous love. Such love, such wondrous love, that God should love a sinner such as I. How wonderful is love like this? That Christ who joins so freely in the scheme, although it meant his death on Calvary, he ever knew my tongue find no blessing than that divine that ransomed me. Such love, such love, such wondrous love, such wondrous love, that God should love a sinner such as I. How wonderful is love like this? That for a woeful outcast such as I, the Father planned, the Savior bled and died, redemption for a worthless sin to buy. Who long had law and grace defy? Such love, such wondrous love, such love, such wondrous love, that God should love such as I. How wonderful is love like this? Now he takes me to his heart as I. He asks me not to free the servant's place, a far off country wandering all again. Wide open are his arms of grace. Such love, such love, such wondrous love, such love, such wondrous love, that God should love a sinner such as I. How wonderful is love like this? Hallelujah. Brothers and sisters, I wish you can experience the love of God. He never came for the righteous people. He came for the sinner. A sinner like me. A sinner like some of us. But He decided to die on the cross of Calvary. He gave his precious blood, and through that blood, we can have eternal life. Because as it is recorded in the Bible, life is in the blood. So he gave to give us his blood to redeem you and me. Oh, precious brother, such love, such wondrous love. Oh, my. Okay, we are going to read from our Bible. We shall read from the book of 1 Thessalonians. I will ask you to stand again, just as we are reading the Word of God, and then we shall sit and follow. 1 Thessalonians, brothers and sisters, we must understand one thing. One day, we shall give our last breath here on earth. And I can promise you, there is life after death. This life that you see. The Bible says, before I go deep, in the book of 1 Thessalonians, chapter 2, I will read verse 13. I know my sister has got some problem of eyes. Don't worry. Just listen, you know. I know you can't read for now. For this cause also, thank we God without ceasing, because when ye received the word of God, which ye heard of us, ye received it not as the word of men, but as it is in truth, the word of God, which effectually worketh also in you that believe. May God bless the reading of this word as I will ask you to sit down. My precious brothers and sisters, today we shall talk briefly about the Word of God. As we have just read, it is the Word of God which is preached that will effectually work in us who believe. And the Word of God is God himself, but in a written form. Listen, brothers, listen, sisters, I will go slowly. In the book of Psalms, chapter 33, you will see, even for our visitors, today, you'll be seeing I will be going from scripture to scripture because I don't want to give anyone my thoughts. It must be the Word of God, nothing else, because the Word of God is God Himself. The Bible says in the book of Psalms, chapter 33. Verse 4, for the word of the Lord is right. I'm not prepared to preach unto you the word of any man, because it's only the word of the Lord that is right. The Bible says, every man is a liar. So if I have to give you my word, I might tell you lies. I'm not here to play. Listen, I'm not playing with your souls. Your souls are very dear to our Creator. He is a Father. That's why we call him Heavenly Father. He does have sons and daughters. I'm not prepared to give you any man's word, but the word of the Lord, because that word is right. And the Bible, and all his works are done in truth. The Lord Jesus Christ says, if you read in John chapter 8, he says, you will know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. And the word of God can only lead us in the truth. And in the word of God, there is no lie. As it is recorded in the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 1, you see, all the promises of God in Jesus are yes and amen. Everything which is promised by God in the Bible are yes and amen. Everything which is written, it will come a time when it must take place. And our God, the one that I'm preaching to you, is the God of realities. In him, I mean Jesus Christ, there is, he said, eternal life, salvation, redemption, healing, joy, peace. You know, you can name it, as it is recorded in the book of Galatians chapter 5. I'm promising you, brothers and sisters, by receiving the word of God in you, you are allowing God, the creator of everything, to come and enter your heart. As it is recorded in the book of Revelation chapter 3 from verse 19, the Lord Jesus Christ is knocking at the doors of our hearts. Listen, brothers, listen, sister, this is very important. Why? He wants to come in. He wants to come in and take ownership of your heart. He is our Lord. He is our Master. And when he comes in your heart, please allow him to go inside and take whatsoever which is contrary to the perfect will of God. Allow the Lord Jesus Christ to come in. Oh my, maybe I will come back here. I would like to read, because I just mentioned it. I must read it. Revelation chapter 3. We shall come back to Psalms. Revelation chapter 3, verse 20. Listen what the Bible says. It is the Lord Jesus Christ speaking. From verse 20. Behold, you know, when you see behold, it needs your attention. Behold, I stand at the door and knock. It is a spiritual door, our hearts. If any man hear my voice and open the door, I will come into him and will sup with him and he with me. To him that overcometh, will I grant to sit with me in my throne, even as also overcame, and am sat down with my Father in his throne. He that hath an ear, let him hear what the Spirit saith unto the churches. You want to come in? Just imagine, brothers, you have supper with Jesus Christ.
What a wonderful thing. What a wonderful fellowship. You sit at the table and you have a supper with Jesus Christ. He wants to come in. Now, the one has got, you know, it's like that door. Someone can be knocking from outside. It's only the one who is inside who has got the key who can open. Just imagine if the of Australia comes to your house and you start knocking. I can promise you, even if you don't like him, you will open the door. Here I'm not talking about the prime minister. I'm talking about the creator of heaven and earth. He wants to come in. Now, whereas we are going back to the book of Psalms chapter 33, how we jump? Oh, man. Listen. Verse 6. Psalms 33. Verse 6, as we say, we are going to talk about the Word of God. Listen. From verse 6, the Bible says, by the words of the Lord were the heavens made, and all the hosts of them by the breath of his mouth. Listen, brothers, listen, sisters. The word of God has the power of transformation. If you read the Bible carefully, you will see from Genesis chapter 1, when you read carefully, the Bible records, and the Lord says, let there be light. There was light. Let them be this, and that was, it became a reality by the word of the Lord. Now, how let that word of the Lord to be, you know, in your heart, in your soul? Because with that word of God, you know, within that word, there is the power of transformation. That's why my Lord Jesus Christ would say, if you speak, things should take place. If you don't doubt in your heart, you can speak and things will take place. Listen, brothers, before I continue. When you read carefully your Bible in the book of Genesis chapter 1, verse 26, the Bible says, when God, our Heavenly Father, was creating everything, the Bible says in Genesis chapter 1, verse 26, let us make man in our own image. I'm lucky, you know, to us. As I'm standing now, I am in the image of my Heavenly Father. Each one of you, as you are sitting there, you are the image of your Heavenly Father. That's why when Jesus Christ came down, he could say, when you are praying, you must say, our Heavenly Father who art in heaven. Our Father who art in heaven. Because he is a Father. If we are created in the image of our Father, the qualities, the attributes, listen, the nature of our Father must be found in us. Church of the Living God, I know many are following me all over. internet, of course. It is only the devil who is coming to put doubt in you, to say, no, you can do it. You can do it. That's why when you read Matthew chapter 28, the Lord Jesus Christ is saying, I have given you power. But it is only the devil who comes and puts doubt in us. Let us doubt our own doubts. And let God, if truly we invite him in our hearts, let him do everything. Because the Bible says, as we read in 1 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 13, that it is the word of God that worketh in us who believe. The first thing that we have to do is to believe. And that's why the Bible says in the book of Isaiah chapter 53, verse 1, that who has believed our report? And unto whom the arm of the Lord is revealed. First of all, we must believe the report from God in order for him to come in. In order for him to reveal himself unto you. If you don't believe him, he can't speak to you. Actually, it is recorded in the book of 1 John chapter 5. It's because of time, I will be giving just some scriptures. It is written, if you disbelieve God, you make him a liar. It's written. Just imagine. Most of us here, we are parents. Before going to work, you tell your young one, say, okay, I'm going to work. This afternoon, I'm going to bring sweets to you. Now, just imagine your son or your daughter telling you, I don't believe you. How are you going to feel? I can see most of you are laughing. Just imagine your son, your daughter tells you that I don't believe you. It will make you cross. It is exactly the same with our Lord Jesus Christ. That's why he said, only believe. This Bible is full of promises from our Heavenly Father. But how many believe those promises? For instance, he said in the book of John chapter 14 from verse 1, that I have gone, you believe in God, believe also in me. I am going to prepare a place for you. And then when I will come, I will take you so that you can be with me where I am. So there is something that we are expecting to experience is the return of Jesus Christ. And to take us from this world where he is. It is recorded in this Bible. Yes, before I forget what I was about to say, Psalms 53, verse 6. By the words of the Lord were the heavens made. And all the host of them by the breath of his mouth. Listen, he gathered the waters of the sea together as a heap. He laid up the depth in storehouses. Let all the earth fear the Lord. Let all the inhabitants of the world stand in the view of him. He said, verse 9, for he spake and it was done. He commanded and it stood fast. By the words, he was not speaking. He was speaking things were done. Being the children of God, it must, when we believe him.
Listen, brothers, before I hear,
when you read your Bible carefully, in the book of 2 Corinthians, chapter 6, from verse 14 to 18, it is recorded that I will dwell in you. The Creator, His perfect will is to dwell in each one of us. That's why He's knocking. He would like to come here. Because He wants to dwell in you. He wants to walk in you, as it is recorded. He said, I will dwell in them. I will walk in them. That is the perfect will of God. Now, how many are prepared to open their hearts for Jesus Christ to come in? Now listen, if the Creator dwelleth in you, can you name a single thing that you'll be unable to do? You see, when we must receive the word of God, we are not here to preach interpretations, we are not here to preach doctrines of any church, we are not here to preach any dogma of any church, we are here to preach the word of God. We are here to invite everyone to open his heart, her heart, to receive God himself, not me. I'm just a vessel, not me. But as I'm speaking to you, I've already experienced many, many things with Jesus Christ. But I can't come and mention them, otherwise we are going to spend the whole day of what the Lord Jesus Christ has done already through me as your servant. As we continue, listen, brothers, listen, sisters. Oh, my. Because of time, let me jump. The same Psalms 33, verse 18. Listen to what the Bible says. Behold, the eye of the Lord is upon them that fear him, upon them that hope in his mercy, to deliver their soul from death and to keep them alive in famine. Listen, brothers, listen, sisters. Verse 20. Our soul waiteth for the Lord. He is our help and our shield. For our hearts shall rejoice in him, because we have trusted in his holy name. Let thy mercy, O Lord, be upon us, according as we hope in thee. Listen, brothers, listen, sisters. Do you know why we came from most of all denominations? The denominations preaching something that they twist, which is not the word of God. No wonder our Lord Jesus Christ would say, the word of God is without any effect unto you, because you are preaching to people your own doctrines. As soon as you put something which is not the word of God. It is not the word of God. It becomes something that belongs to that denomination. That's why most of us, we were kicked out from denominations, from men. Can you imagine? For instance, the Bible says, for someone to be a bishop or to be a pastor, he must be the husband of one wife. Now, how can I call someone my pastor, someone who is not married? And because their denomination are telling them, of course, through their headquarters here on earth, that if you want to serve God, you must be single. Already that is a problem, because the Bible says, how can you lead the church of the living God if you are unable to rule your own family, your own children, your own wife? The Bible speaks about the baptism in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ for, no, let me read it, because there are times when I must read some of these scriptures, though I know them, but I must read so that we can also see what the Bible says. Before we read, I want to let you know that according to the Bible, in the book of Ephesians chapter 4, The Bible says in Ephesians chapter 4, I will read from verse 4. Ephesians chapter 4 from verse 4, the Bible says, there is one body and one spirit, even as ye are called in one hope of your calling. Listen to this fire. One Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is above all, and through all, and in you all. Not three, but today we have the doctrine of Trinity. Trinity speaking about three gods in one. The Bible says there is only one God. In other words, Trinity is not from God. Trinity is not the word of God. The Bible here, as we have read, one God, one faith, one baptism, one God, not three, one God. Listen, brothers, listen, sisters. As we are talking about one baptism, as I was about to read in the book of Acts chapter 2, I'm reading from verse 37. The Bible says, now, when they heard this, they were pricked in their hearts and said unto Peter and to the rest of their apostles, men and brethren, what shall we do? Bible question, Bible answer. You know, some of us who have been several times in Israel, we had an opportunity to visit
the upper chamber where the Holy Spirit came down for the first time. And the upper chamber is exactly as it was in the days of our Lord Jesus Christ. Exactly the same. In that upper chamber, when the Holy Spirit came from above, as it was promised by our Lord Jesus Christ, people start speaking. I mean, the disciples of Jesus Christ, there were 120. They start speaking in tongues. So the people who were around, you know, I mean, outside of that upper chamber, they thought that these 120 disciples were drunk. And now Peter, that I always consider as the first preacher, when the Holy Spirit came down, Peter starts speaking. As he was speaking, it was the Holy Spirit speaking through Peter. People could see Peter standing, speaking, but it was the Holy Spirit speaking through Peter. And the Holy Spirit is the Spirit of our Creator. Listen, brothers, listen, sisters. Even those who are following us online, that day when the Holy Spirit was speaking through Peter, it was God speaking through Peter to deny what God spoke through Peter is to deny God, is to fight God. And the only baptism, we are going to read about it. People came, they saw that there was something supernatural that was taking place. That's why they asked Peter and the rest of the apostles, what shall we do? Now listen, the answer. Then Peter said unto them, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, now listen, for the remission of sins, and ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost is a gift. A gift is something that you don't deserve. But a gift is a gift if you accept it and receive it. If you don't like, I can say, brother, I would like to give you this watch as a gift. But if you don't like it, it won't be a gift. Because you say, no, I don't like it. Now, the Holy Spirit is the gift that God is giving to everyone. The problem is not with God. The problem is with us. Are you ready to receive that gift? If you say, no, I don't like it, it's a democracy, it's up to you. But I know the children of God will hear the voice of God and they will follow it. They won't fight the word of God. Now listen, verse 89. For the promise is unto you and to your children, and to all that are afar off, even as many as the Lord our God shall call. And with many other words, he testify and exhort, saying, save yourselves from this untoward generation. Then, listen, they that gladly received his word were baptized. And the same day, there were added unto them about 3,000 souls. They received the word of God with joy. That day, 3,000 people were baptized in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. As the Bible says, there's only one baptism. You will never see in the Bible a single person who has been baptized in the name of Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. No. They must mention the name of Jesus Christ. You know, I always give this simple example. You may come to me and say, my brother, I'm broke, I need money. I say, oh, okay. Go to Westpac. The manager of that Westpac here in Melbourne knows me. Go and tell him. I have come in the name of the doctor, because I'm a doctor. In the name of the father, because I'm also father, I'm having children. In the name of husband, because I have a wife. In the name of son, because I have parents. You can mention all these titles. He will say, my friend, are you serious? What is his name? If you don't mention my name, the manager of Westpac won't give you anything until you mention my name. That's why it is even recorded in the book of Colossians, that chapter 3, that whatsoever that we do, we must do everything in the name of Jesus Christ. Because when you pronounce that name of Jesus Christ, the demons will flee from you. Because that name of Jesus Christ has got power. That name of Jesus Christ is the name of God Himself. That name of Jesus Christ is, you know, the Jehovah of the Old Testament is Jesus Christ in the New Testament. Listen, brothers, listen, sisters, I beg you. This morning, I've got a lot of scriptures written, but, you know, I can see I'm having only 13 minutes remaining, but listen, brothers, listen, sisters. With this name of Jesus Christ, you have access to heavenly kingdom. But the problem is, we must receive Him. We must accept Him. As we are reading, He's knocking. He wants to come and dwell in you. He wants to, you know, he wants to be, listen, the master of everything. Oh my. And of course, when you give room to Him, Philippians chapter 1, verse 6 will take place in you. Philippians chapter 1, verse 6 says, be confident of this very thing. The one who has started the good work in you will complete it. Listen, brothers, as I keep on saying, the word of God, as it is recorded in the book of 1 John chapter 5, it is easy. I've been asking everyone, is it difficult to open your heart in order for Jesus Christ to come in? Just open your heart. I told you, the Prime Minister Morrison comes, knocks at the door of your heart, the door of your house.
can promise you, if you know that it is Him, you will open it quickly. But here we are not talking about the prime minister, we are talking about the Creator. Is it difficult, brother? Is it difficult to say, yes, Lord, here I am? When you read in the book of Luke chapter 1, because of time I'm not going to mention it, there was a lady that I always call my sister, that I will meet in heaven. Her name was Mary. She received the message. And then when that angel appeared to her, she didn't fight against that word. She just said, let it be according to, let me read it. Luke chapter 1. No. I can't just mention it like that. Luke chapter 1. Luke chapter 1. Okay. Because of time, let me read verse 30. And the angel said unto her, fear not, Mary, for thou hast found favor with God. And behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb, and bring forth a son, and shall call his name Jesus. He shall be great, and shall be called the Son of the Highest. And the Lord God shall give unto him the throne of his father David. Now, okay, I just want to jump. Listen what Mary said. Mary didn't refuse. The only thing she said, then said Mary, verse 34, then said Mary unto the angel, how shall this be, seeing I know not a man? And the angel answered and said unto her, the Holy Ghost shall come upon thee, and the power of the Highest shall overshadow thee. Listen, brothers, listen, sisters. When you accept the word of God, because I said yesterday, today, and forever, if you accept the word of God, the thing that happened with Mary should also happen with you. The Bible says, the Holy Ghost shall come upon thee, and the power of the Highest shall overshadow thee. And you know what happened with Mary? Jesus was born. If you receive the word of God in you, Jesus must also be born in you. Now we are talking spiritually now. That's why, listen, brothers, that's why the Bible says in the book of Psalms, let me find it, Psalms 82, yes, Psalms 82, verse 6. Psalms 82, verse 6. I don't know if you say amen to this scripture. Psalms 82, verse 6. I am said, ye are gods. Can you say amen to that scripture? Excuse me. Listen. If my father is God, when you see a dog, a little one from a dog, he's dog. He's a dog also. Listen, brothers, listen, sisters, I'm reading from the Bible. That's why, as I was reading from Genesis chapter 1, verse 26, The Lord God said, let us make man in our own image. No wonder Psalms is saying, I'm reading it again, I have said, ye are gods. I believe that I'm a small god, having the nature of my father. And the Bible continues, and all of you are children of the Most High. Hallelujah, brothers and sisters. I don't know if you see what I'm saying. That's why I don't want to be told, you know, as someone was telling me, no, we are the children of Catholics. I say, okay, you can be the children of Catholics. You can be the children of Jehovah Witnesses, can be the children of whosoever you wish to be, but I won't see my name among those who are children of Catholics, Protestants, whosoever. No, I'm one of the children of the Most High. That's where I'd like all of us to be this morning. God wants to dwell in you. He wants to dwell in each one of us. In other words, when you are on the streets of Maryborough, people can see young men, young women, elderly men, elderly women, with all this weakness of this physical body, but not ideally. Because of time, the Lord willing, we shall continue next time. That's why the Lord could say, the children of God, as it is recorded in Matthew chapter 5, we are the light of the world. God is light. The children of God must be light. So wherever you are going, people will see. I can promise you, wherever I'm going, I have testimonies. I say, yeah, we can see that you are different. Even in terms of profession, behavior, everything. Why? God is dwelling in me. I believe it. And I like it also. You know, it might sound simple. Being a human being like me, God to dwell in me. Because of time, we shall read the next time. There was a man like you and me. His name was Joshua. There was a time when he was in a battle field. He says, no, I don't want darkness to come, otherwise you are going to lose this battle. He looked and saw the sun, S-U-N. He spoke, sun, stand there. Can you imagine a human being full of mistakes like you and me could give an instruction to the sun, S-U-N, to stop, not moving, and the sun stood for 24 hours. It is recorded in the Bible. Now, Joshua is not here. There must be men and women who should have the same faith like Joshua. Do you know why? God was in Joshua. Joshua is no more here. There must be people full of mistakes, full of passion,
full of many things, we can also experience exactly what happened with Joshua. But in order for that to take place, we must accept the word of God here, in our hearts, in our souls. Brothers and sisters, that's why you see me in Melbourne, I'm crying. I wish God can give me an opportunity to talk to the entire city. But I know, by faith, it will happen one day. God in you. We can't mention efforts. How? It will never happen. It will never be in you. God in you. You can't do things to hurt your neighbor. Never. God in you. You are a peacemaker wherever you go. God in you. You are the salt. You know, salt attacks, you know. It will attack, it will attract everyone. Oh, my time is over. We shall continue the Lord with it. Can we sing a song and then we shall pray? Because I don't want to take you more than an hour, as I promised. We shall sing song. I would like us to sing song number 90. Song 90. Song 90. He is coming soon. In these, the closing days of time, what joy the glorious hope affords, that soon no wondrous fruits are blind. He shall reign, King of kings and Lord of lords,
coming soon,
he's coming soon, he's coming soon. With joy, we welcome him returning. He may be nigh or noon, we know he's coming soon. The signs are on earth and air, or painted on the starry sky. God's faithful witnesses declare that the coming of the Savior draweth nigh. He's coming soon, he's coming soon. With joy we welcome his return. It may be morning, it may be night or noon, we know he's coming soon. The day in Christ whom yet has light, in countless numbers all shall rise. When through the portals of the sky, he shall come to prepare our paradise.
He's coming soon,
he's coming soon, he's coming. So, rejoice, you welcome his returning. It may be morning, it may be night or noon, we know he's coming soon. And we who live yet remain, but I shall meet our faithful Lord. This hope we cherish not in vain, but we comfort one another by his word.
Coming soon,
he's coming soon, he's coming soon. With joy we welcome him early. It may be morning, it
Light on you, we know it's coming soon.
Can we stand up for the week of prayer? As we are closing for today, our Heavenly Father, once more we thank you for thy words. We know there is nothing better than the word of God. Father, I just spoke as a man, but come and speak to each one of us. Be the after speaker. Reveal thyself unto thy children. Because I know for sure, as you said, my sheep will hear my voice and will follow me. Heavenly Father, I know many are connected right now through the internet. Speak to each one of them, because the time is very short. Thy return is imminent. Oh, Heavenly Father, I know, as it is recorded, if you speak, thy words must give the effect. Oh, Heavenly Father, who are we without thee? Come, dwell in each one of us. If there are sick people in our midst, even among those who are listening to us, you are still a greatest healer, as it is recorded in Isaiah chapter 53, verse 5. Oh, I know thy arm is not short. Heal all the sick in our midst. You are still the greatest physician. You know exactly that out there, the enemy is waiting to fight against us. But with thee, we are more than overcomers, because the victory is ours. Thank you, Father, for thy word. Be with each one of us until, if it is thy will, for us to meet again. In Jesus Christ's name, I have prayed. Amen. Now we may be seated, and then I will sing the one. Let us sing. We shall sing one more song, and then we shall depart. Song number 125 in our book. Then I see something that you prepared for us. Because tea and coffee and all of us, so we shall come. Song 125.
Gone from my heart, the world and all its charms. Now through the blood, I'm safe from all alarms. Down at the cross, my heart is bending low. The precious blood of Jesus blesses white as snow. I love him. I love him. Because he first loved me. And purchased my salvation. On Calvary's tree. Once I was lost and went down deep in sin, to passion fierce within. Once was afraid to trust a loving God, but now every strength through Jesus' blood. I love him, I love him, because he first loved me, and purchased my salvation on Calvary's Once I was bound, but now I am set free. Once I was blind, but now the light I see. Once I was dead, but now in Christ I live, to tell the world around the peace that He does give. I love Him, I love Him, because He first loved me and purchased my salvation on Calvary's tree.
May God richly bless you. We shall meet next time in the Lord's name.